In today's video, we will discuss about different types of cranial nerves. About cranial nerves in general. Cranial nerves are the nerves that emerge directly from the brain, including the brainstem. So, all cranial nerves emerge from the brain, including brainstem. The olfactory nerve, that is number one cranial nerve, and the optic nerve, that is the second cranial nerve, emerge from the cerebrum. Remaining all 10 pairs arise from the brainstem. So, in the brain, there are two points of origin for cranial nerve, cerebrum and the brainstem. From the cerebrum, olfactory nerves and optic nerve emerge, and from the brainstem, remaining 10 pairs originate. Grossly, all cranial nerves have a nucleus. With the exception of olfactory nerve and optic nerve, all nuclei are present in the brainstem. We have told already olfactory nerve and optic nerve, they arise from the cerebrum, so their nuclei is in the cerebrum. Remaining all cranial nerve nuclei lies in the brainstem. Then each cranial nerve is paired and it is present on both sides. There are conventionally 12 pairs of cranial nerve. Altogether in human body there are 12 pairs of cranial nerve. They are numbered from 1 to 12 with the Roman numerals. Cranial nerve relay information between the brain and parts of the body. The cranial nerve are considered as the important components of peripheral nervous system. Although they origin within the brain, they are considered as a part of peripheral nervous system. Here in this picture you can see the origin of different or 12 pairs of cranial nerve. This is olfactory nerve number 1, optic nerve. These two nerves originate from the cerebrum or cerebral cortex from different parts. Remaining all originate from the brainstem. This is the structure of brainstem. So, trigeminal, facial, glossopharyngeal, vagus, accessory, hypoglossal, vestibulocochlear, abducens, trochlear and oculomotor. All these nerves originate from the brainstem. Olfactory and optic originate from the cerebrum, remaining all originate from the brainstem. In this image, this is the cross section showing the base of the brain with all the cranial nerves as in the previous picture. This is the cross section of the brain and here you can see this is the base of the brain and all the cranial nerves are shown here. Olfactory nerve, optic nerve from the cerebrum, remaining all from the brainstem from different parts. In this image, we can see the exit of 12 cranial nerve from the brain or from the base of the brain to different parts of the body where it is up. The olfactory nerve exit through the cribriform plate, that is here. The optic nerve exit through optic canal, this is optic canal. Then through superior orbital fissure, 4 cranial nerve emerges. They are oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve, ophthalmic nerve and abducens nerve. This is the superior orbital fissure. Then through foramen rotundum, maxillary nerve exit. This is the foramen rotundum. Then through foramen ovale, that is here, mandibular nerve exit. Then this opening is the internal acoustic meatus, through which facial nerve and vestibulocochlear nerve exit. Then this opening is hypoglossal canal, through which hypoglossal nerve exit. And here you can see jugular foramen, through which 3 nerves comes out of brain. They are glossopharyngeal nerve, vagus nerve, accessory nerve. Now we will see about little details of each nerve. First nerve is called the olfactory nerve. It is sensory in nature. It originates from olfactory receptor nerve cells in the cerebrum. It exits through the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone. The second is optic nerve. It is also sensory in nature. It originates from the back of the eyeball and it exits through the optic foramen. The third is oculomotor. It is motor in nature. origin in the midbrain. That is, it originates from the brainstem, that is from the midbrain. It exits through superior orbital fissure. The fourth one is trochlear nerve. It is motor in nature. It originates from posterior surface of midbrain, or in simply midbrain, and it exits through superior orbital fissure. The next nerve, the cranial nerve 5, that is the trigeminal nerve. It has three divisions: ophthalmic nerve, maxillary nerve, and a mandibular nerve. These are the divisions of the areas that supply, or the region that supply by the trigeminal nerve. The mandibular nerve supply the mandibular division, that is here. Then maxillary zone, this is the maxillary zone, and this is the ophthalmic zone. This is the trigeminal nerve that divides into mandibular nerve, maxillary nerve, and ophthalmic zone, and this is the area supplied by all three branches. About the first branch, ophthalmic nerve, that is sensory in nature. It supplies cornea, skin of forehead, scalp, eyelids and nose, mucous membrane of paranasal sinuses and nasal cavity. It originates from pons, that is brainstem, and it exits through superior orbital fissure. About the maxillary nerve, it is sensory in nature. It originates from the pons and it exits through foramen ovale. About mandibular nerve, it is motor in nature. It originates from pons and it exits through foramen rotundum. And the last branch, mandibular nerve, also has sensory supply. It is motor and as well as sensory. It originates from pons and escape through or exit through foramen rotundum. The sixth cranial nerve is abducens nerve. It is motor in nature. It help or it supply lateral rectus muscle of the eyeball. It originates from medulla oblongata and exit through superior orbital fissure. Seventh cranial nerve is called facial nerve. It is mixed, that is, it has both motor function and a sensory function. Motor, it supplies muscles of face and scalp, stapedus muscle, posterior belly of digastric muscle, stylohyoid muscle. And sensory, taste from anterior two-third of the tongue and from the floor of the mouth and palate. And also it is secretomotor. It helps in the secretion of salivary glands, that is submandibular and sublingual salivary glands, lacrimal glands, and the glands of nose and palate. It originates from medulla oblongata. It exits through internal acoustic meatus, facial canal, and stylomastoid foramen. The eighth cranial nerve is called the vestibulocochlear nerve or auditory nerve. It is sensory in nature. It supplies the ear, the vestibule, and the cochlea. It originates from medulla and it exits through internal acoustic meatus. The ninth nerve is called a glossopharyngeal nerve. It is also mixed function, that is motor, sensory, and secretomotor. Motor, it supplies stylopharyngeus muscle. The tenth cranial nerve is glossopharyngeal nerve. It originates from medulla oblongata and it exits through jugular foramen. 10th one is vagus nerve. It is motor in nature. It originates from medulla and it exits through jugular foramen. The 11th one is accessory nerve. It is also motor in nature, originates from medulla oblongata and exits through jugular foramen. And the last, the 12th pair is hypoglossal nerve. It is motor in nature, again originates from medulla and exits through hypoglossal canal. Thus we have come to the end of 12 cranial nerves. This image we will discuss all together, or we will summarize all together the different cranial nerves. First one is olfactory, it is sensory, supply the nose. Second is optic, that is sensory, it supply the eye. Third is oculomotor. It is motor in nature. It supplies all eye muscles except supplied by fourth and sixth. Fourth one is trochlear. It supplies superior oblique muscle of the eye. And sixth is abducens. It supplies motor, sorry, external rectus muscle, and it is motor in nature. Then coming to the fifth one, that is trigeminal, it is supply the sensory, face, sinuses and teeth. The motor part supply muscles of mastication. Then the eighth one is vestibulocochlear, and it is sensory in nature. It supply the inner ear. It is also called auditory nerve. The ninth one is glossopharyngeal. It is motor and sensory. The motor part supply pharyngeal musculature, and the sensory part supply posterior part of tongue, tonsil and pharynx. The 11th one is accessory nerve, and it is motor. It supplies sternocleidomastoid and trapezius muscles of the head and neck. Then 12th one is hypoglossal, and it is motor. It helps to move the muscles of the tongue. Then coming to the vagus nerve, that is 10th one, it is very important nerve because it supply most of the important visceral organs. Its motor component supply heart, lungs, bronchi and GIT. Sensory part supply heart, lungs, bronchi, trachea, larynx, pharynx, gastrointestinal tract and external ear. In short, its motor part supply the heart, the entire respiratory tract and the GIT and also external ear. About the 7th one, that is the facial nerve, it is motor in nature, it supply muscles of the face. Thus we have come to the end of overview of cranial nerve. In this image you can see the 12 pairs of cranial nerve and the parts supplied by them. The first one, it supply the nose, it sends the smell, so here it is in the place of the nose it is written as 1. The second one is optic, related to supply of the eye, so 2. The number 2 is written in the place of the eyeball. The third is oculomotor, which helps in the upward movement of the eyeball. So the third is written in the top. Then the sixth and the fourth one supply or help in the downward movement of the eyeball. Fourth one is downward movement, and the sixth one helps in the lateral movement of the eyeball. And the fifth one supply the entire face because it has 3 divisions. Maxillary, mandibular and ophthalmic. Then here you can see the 7th cranial nerve, that is a facial, supply the muscles of the face. So on both sides 7 is written like this. Then in the place of the eye there is 8th cranial nerve, that is auditory, which supply the inner ear. Then 9, 10 and 12 supply tongue with a different function. And the 11th one written on side because it supply both neck muscles on both side. Thus in this cartoon image you can see all 12 pairs of cranial nerve with its part supplied. Then here is a mnemonic to remember the 12 cranial nerves and its type of function. The mnemonic is on occasion our trusty truck acts funny. Very good vehicle anyhow. So O olfactory, O optic and O oculomotor. 3 O. Then T for trochlear, the other T for trigeminal. Then A for abducens, F for facial, V for vestibulocochlear, G for glossopharyngeal, V for vagus, A for accessory and H for hypoglossal. So on occasion our trusty truck acts funny, very good vehicle anyhow. Here we can see the different types of function or the nature of each nerve. The mnemonic is, some say marry money, but my brother says big brains matter more. Here olfactory nerve, it is sensory in nature, optic nerve again sensory, oculomotor again motor, trochlear again motor, trigeminal it is both, that is both motor and sensory, abducens nerve again motor, facial both sensory and motor, vestibular it is sensory, glossopharyngeal both, vagus both B, accessory nerve motor M and hypoglossal motor M. That is the end of discussion about 12 pairs of cranial nerve. Thanks for listening. Please subscribe and share.